You know, there's just some days you're so mad that your hair just stands up on end. Well, today is one of those days where everyone in the media, everyone in politics, everyone everywhere is like, oh, soft landing. There shall be no recession. And the people are like, huh?
Well, I was just working at Big Lots and it's now gone.
No, Bravo, did you see the initial jobless claims declined by most in nearly a year?
Stock market go up.
Well, that is unless you own things like Airbnb or Bumble. I mean, if we could just take a little peeksy here, Airbnb shares plunge. Why is this? Slowing U.S. demand as consumer downturn worsens. Oh, this just in, breaking news. Homeowners increasingly tap equity lines as savings rates plummet. So this isn't a good thing. Actually, the only homie in the hood that's even kind of covering his the thing, that backside, Jamie Dimon, says he still sees a recession on the horizon. So it's not his fault. Jamie has nothing to do with that, right? That $35 trillion, is that what you're covering there? Is you guys have to pay $268,000 back today. Though also, just FYI, you never want to spend more than you take in, like $2 trillion that you have to pay back. And also, just FYI, go back in time to the Great Depression. They weren't deficit spending by $2 trillion. If you were to calculate the way the numbers were then and now, we'd probably have a negative 40, I'm guessing, you could fact check me, a negative 40% GDP. And again, what makes my hair stand up is they put it on you. And then you're like, I turn off the lights when you leave. Hey, babe, we're going to have to tap our home equity line. Well, your wife works at CVS and, oh, hey, look, $2 billion cost cutting effort. Sorry you lost your job. Well, babe, we still have our passive income of our Airbnb, but no one's booked it this year. And then there was this cat who, okay, I'll give it to you, Andy, who is a, you see, this is what it always is. Former CKE restaurant CEO. It's always former. It's like, no one says anything when they're in. Then when they step down, they're like, oh, let me tell you. And how this has anything to do with Kamala Harris called out for having no information on economic plan. Okay, I don't care. I mean, we kind of already know what the plan is, right? Oh, that's it. Your taxes. We need some more. Ex-fast food CEO rips economists. U.S. recession read. People are suffering. And that is why I make this video today, because I'm a little upset. As I see the entire economy going down in a gigantic, wait, dumpster fire, and then people on the news are like, no, it's everything's great. Majority of traders pricing in a 84% chance of a Fed rate cut in September. I say all you have to do is just look at the 2-year if you want to know if they're cutting or when they're cutting. They are so behind. You see orange line? Orange line needs to catch up with blue line. And for those of you that are like, but it went up today. Okay, markets are going down and then they have 7, 8, 9 bounce. So if you want to know why the market went up today or why it went down or why the Fed pivots or why the bond market does what it does, just follow the chart. I know everyone's so excited about the NASDAQ that we made so much money on the way down. Bounces off the 200. Now all you have to do is get over that little red line. And for as crazy it might sound, I will be in. And that goes for the S&P 500. That would also go for the Dow Jones Industrial Average. Also, if you'd like to learn how to swing trade, 80% off. Link in the description. And you can take any course you want, even my crypto one. Why is Bitcoin bouncing? Well, 7, 8, there you go. Also, I did give you levels for my investors, right? Gold investors, Bitcoin investors. It was right there. Your order got filled right at 52,338. Also, if you thought it was going to bounce off of the 200, you could have put something in there too. Let's look at the percentages of all of this recession speak. JP Morgan Chase CEO Jamie Dimon says he believes that the odds of a soft landing for the economy are around 35 to 40%. Okay, I'm going to shave off that 4 and just leave that 0% there. You got the SOM rule. Ta-da! You have an inverted yield curve that is reinverting almost there. For some reason, it just takes, right, that when the stock market goes down, everyone's like, okay, guess we're in a recession. Bob, it was a day. But when asked if he changed his view from February that markets were too optimistic on recession risk, Dimon said the odds were about the same. I will tell you, this is how it goes down in the playbook. It will be an emergency Fed meeting, right? Nope, all soft landing. Until the whole thing burns down. It will be some wacky black swan event. It'll be something like, oh, what the carry trade? And everyone's like, what's a carry trade? Which I've explained a few times and I try to make it easy. Let's see how well I can do it. Okay, you have, let's say you want to take out a loan. But instead of using dollars, you use yuan. Or you use the yen. And you go, oh my gosh, the yen is at 0%. I could have money at 0%. I will take out a $1 million loan in yen. Now, instead of yen or yuan, let's say it's Bitcoin. And you take out the loan in Bitcoin, which is whichever one you want. And you go buy a bond or you go buy a stock. Oh, hey, how about Nvidia? That's what they're doing. Or they go, the bond would be, say, an easy one. Here's one. It is a five, giving you 5.4%. That is a 1 month government bond. Oh my gosh, I'm making 5%. I'm borrowing money at zero, making 5%. And then all of a sudden, that underlying asset, Bitcoin, starts going up. But you're like, it's not supposed to do that. So you get rid of, you sell. They are saying right now that we're about 75% of the way through the squeeze. I don't know, that was a tough one. You know, the brain goes really fast and then you try to catch up to it with your words. Now, the probability of a recession in 2024 is elevated. Thanks, Goat, for this one. And I say it's really elevated. Now, just look at this. These gray bars. Recession. Where are we at? We're way up there. Look, if we were to go way back here. Oh, we're in a recession. We're way down there. Oh, no, we have a 10% chance of a recession. We have a 40% chance of a recession. Nope. Recession. Every single time. And we are way up there. Even if I were to take everything that I'm giving you, from the SOM rule to an inverted yield curve to all the probabilities, comparing it to 1987, oh, that's weird. It's multiplying. Oh, and it's also weird that temporary help requirement is collapsing. See, this is what happens in a recession. It collapses. Have you ever seen a collapse like that? I haven't. Well, except for recessions. Recession, because you're not going for that temporary. Now look at this. That's a weak one down there. Recession. But you don't need temporary help. I got this. Actually, you guys aren't even dating. That would be Bumble, right? Everyone is so broke they don't even date. How much did Bumble? Wow, that was gnarly. But I think the charts could have predicted it. You have been under the Bravo 9 since you collapsed here. Like, oh, I think time in the market's always better than time in the market. And one day shaves off 40%. There we go. I'm sure it'll come back from $5. How about Airbnb? Same thing. Wow. Under that 200, guys, please. Swing trading course. Learn the 200. You break that. Right when it breaks, boom. I'm going to measure from here to here. You are currently down 21.7%. Now, for some of you, you're like, well, it's Airbnb's up today. I don't know what's my percentage here. Yeah, why is this? 789, purple. You can't pull it that hard. It's going to come back up. Now, for those of you like, should I click that little button, get in a little swing trade? The answer is no. I mean, if you want to click anything, if your TV is currently on, go turn it off. That's Tom Lee. This cat, it's always up, right? Always. We could be Great Depression. Well, it's going up. A sharp reversal. This cat is glass, always a fill. Johnny Bravo, always filled with bleach. A sharp reversal in stock market's fear gauge means the worst is over for investors. So for all of you investors, you have plenty of time to still pile in. Also, don't look at stories like this as layoffs are a last resort, looming for more companies. Firms cutting back on hiring, hours, vacancies have fallen. Labor hoarding has brought feds more time to tame inflation. All these signs that you see all around everywhere you go, they're going to come down, a new business is going to go in, as rising household debt and shrinking incomes are setting the stage for a recession. No, I mean, top economists. Who are these guys? They've been saying this the whole time. Come on. It's David Rosenberg. This guy is a broken clock. Don't worry about all this. The government has your back because they're just going to spend through it. And then all of a sudden you're going to go, wait, Where did I leave all my money? Oh, that's right. I left it with the government because your current tax rate is at 38%. Plus, if you live in Navin Grusom's little state, tack on another 15%. You're probably clearing over half of all your money goes to the government to pay for the government bills. And you wonder why they don't have an economic plan, because it's pretty easy because they have business owners like me that pay the taxes. But anywho, thanks for hanging out. Thanks for being fans. I'm Stephen Van Meter, and I'll see you tomorrow.